enemy, one that is antagonistic to another, something harmful or deadly. For those with eyes to see, humanity is currently under attack by an antagonistic and deadly foe, an enemy that must hide in the shadows to survive. But there is always a money trail, and money is their only real power. So to find the real enemy, we must follow the money. In the documentary Monopoly, Who Owns the World, Tim Gielen does an excellent job of doing this. While there appears to be hundreds of independent companies producing food, they are practically all owned by the same small group of companies. These companies are controlled by their top shareholders, financial institutions such as Berkshire Hathaway, Vanguard, BlackRock, and State Street. This is also who owns Silicon Valley, big tech, the airline industry, the steel industry, agriculture, the textile and clothing industry, both the oil and solar panel industry, tobacco, alcohol, pharmaceutical, electronics, and banking. Just about everything in today's modern world is owned and controlled by these same financial institutions, who are also invested in each other, forming a pyramid of financial power topped by BlackRock and Vanguard. BlackRock loans money to the Federal Reserve Bank, advises them, and developed their software system. BlackRock itself is owned by Vanguard, and Vanguard, sitting on top of the world pyramid, keeps its shareholders private. But we know that the majority of wealth has been accumulated by inheritance and monopoly, and the same few families have owned most of the world for generations. Families such as Rothschild, Rockefeller, DuPont, Morgan, and Bush. Operating through nonprofit foundations, these unelected families are able to rule over the world like kings. This is the way it has always been, whether it be via pharaoh, royalty, papal supremacy, dictator, or investment banker. Mankind has always been managed by the rich and powerful. Freedom is a dream yet to be fully realized in this world. After the American Revolution, our forefathers gave us the tools to realize this dream of self-governance in the Constitution and the Bill of Rights. Tools that will be stripped away unless mankind decides to stand and face their enemy.
Here we need a vast military-style campaign to marshal the strength of the global private sector. With trillions at its disposal, far beyond global GDP, and with the greatest respect, beyond even the governments of the world's leaders, it offers the only real prospect of achieving fundamental economic transition.
For InfoWars.com, this is Greg Reese.